craziest bastards I've ever met in my life! I love everyone!
Crazy Bastards, Sons of Wrestling, Fastlane Breakdown, and not the outcome everyone wanted, but a pretty goddamn kick-ass show. There was some great wrestling tonight, and that's what you get from this. In the end, oh my god, the just what Brock Lesnar took. Holy shit, he got his ass beat, although he did beat some ass himself. He looked very strong. I predicted Bray Wyatt would have come out and did something, but there was no shenanigans outside of these three men. Just awesome work together by Ambrose and Reigns to, take out the beast somewhat, but the end with Reigns winning, it's going to get shit all over, but it's the story that they were building, and, they could have done the right thing here and done a thing with Ambrose, and then when Rollins came back, that would have been a great thing, but it'll be good, although, when Rollins comes back, if Reigns is still champ at that time. So, AJ Jericho match, just freaking phenomenal. That was kick-ass. Even Kalisto Del Rio's pre-show match was pretty damn good. Sasha and Becky versus Tamina and Naomi, that was a goddamn decent match, and I thought you were going to get a little more in between Becky and Sasha there, but that didn't happen. But let's kick it off, like I said, pre-show, Del Rio, Kalisto, 2 out of 3 falls, and Del Rio doesn't give no fucks about the first one, and gets a DQ out of that. then we go into, like I said, this is a pretty decent match, and Del Rio is just dirty as hell. Tries to rip the mask off of Kalisto. Kalisto gets the back part of it ripped off, but his mask stays on, and just phenomenal wrestling between the two. Del Rio, I'll tell you what, that guy can sell good. Like, he puts together a match pretty good. He's calling the show in this match, and he usually does. Del Rio, I give him that. A lot of people hate him, but the guy is really good. So if you don't like Del Rio, look at the positive stuff, because he does phenomenal work. So, and in the end here, Kalisto picks up the win and retains his championship. So it looks like finally Del Rio will be out of that picture, thank goodness. And it was pretty cool. I liked it. Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch versus Tamina and Naomi. You know, it was a pretty decent match. Both girls got in their stuff. The only thing at the end with, you had Sasha going for the pin. Becky came in, she had her in the back, the bank statement. Becky came in, she did touch the two, so you would have thought it would have broke it up, but it didn't anyway. Point is, bank statement finish, and Sasha Banks also puts in, Becky Lynch puts in the arm bar there. So, moving on to another great match, Kevin Owens versus Dolph Ziggler. Holy shit, this match was killer, sick, wicked, awesome, and all cool 80s fucking words. Anyway, point is, I really dug this match. What did you guys think? Comment down below about Kevin Owens and how he went, and I love after this match. Holy shit, we had some super kicks galore. In the end, though, you get the pop-up powerbomb for the victory, but when he got that belt, he goes and slaps it down in front of Michael Cole. I just love the feud that he has with Michael Cole out of nowhere. It's just great. So it's really cool. Owens is just, and he was over in Ziggler's hometown, which was awesome. So I really dug that match. Killed it. And I can't wait to see what happens for KO Mania. So I designed a new shirt, so go check out the site. Merch link is in the description. I put that on a few social media things, and hopefully you've seen it. It's pretty badass. I like it. Pretty cool. Then we got the Wyatts. I didn't see this happening. Versus Big Show, Ryback, and Kane. And Ryback gets over. Yes, he's going to earn a spot in Botchamania with those running knees because he had a little too much momentum on one. You can't. When you're top heavy, man, that shit like that can happen. So it's not necessarily a botch, but hey, people fuck up. But he delivered the shell shock in the end to Harper. Although I wish Harper got in a little more offense. I wish Harper just won the whole goddamn thing, and that would have been awesome. But Big Show, Ryback, and Kane victorious here. And I did like Big Show's like heart and enthusiasm when he locked in that chokehold on Braun Strowman. So I think that's going to be a WrestleMania match. Big Show versus Braun Strowman. It'll be all right. But I want to see the heart of Big Show. No more of this flip-flopping shit. Just show that. And that's cool. Then we got Brie Bella versus Charlotte. Brie Bella had a kick-ass match. She wore Daniel Bryan's kick pads. They looked ugly as hell, like when he wore them. But hey, she was doing good until she hurt her knee. Figure eight finish. Ric Flair didn't have to do shit. Charlotte moves on, and this was kind of expected. So, and then Styles Jericho tore the house down. Just awesome. And Chris Jericho kicked out of the Styles Clash. So are they trying to end that Styles Clash? Because it looks like he's having some trouble. We're in WWE now, the major leagues, like he said, you know, backstage in his Q&A. He's having trouble hoisting people up to put that move in. So it looks like they're trying to get away from that move, although they get to show it, and which everybody pops for it. But man, when people are that big, it looks awkward. So I think, yes, it's maybe time to get away from that move. And he has injured. Not his fault, because the other people are not supposed to tuck their chin. They're supposed to, you know, lean back. But anyway, the point is AJ Styles victorious here with the calf crusher. And Jericho played it awesome. He did all the heel work here at the end to get the crowd in AJ's corner, because it was pretty much 50-50 split. I dug that. He put in the lion tamer a few times, and it was cool. Cool-ass match. I dug it. And Jericho, in the end, looks like he wants to keep going, and AJ Styles says, "You want to keep going? We can do this now." Turns into a handshake. Seemed like a passing of the torch, and definitely the right guy to do so. So that's that story. I dug it, and it was pretty cool. Then you got, this was awkward, Cutting Edge Peep Show on a pay-per-view, so not a wrestling match, but the guests of the New Day, they come out, we get some exchanges, and Edgy Christian believe that the New Day have studied them and then did the same shit. They're just copying them. And then they talk about the League of Nations just out of nowhere. League of Nations finally come out, New Day leaves, and League of Nations just gets shitty with Edge and Christian. So they leave too and call them the International House of Dumbasses. Perfect. And Edge and Christian and New Day celebrate outside of the ring. Pretty cool. And yeah, League of Nations is just bad. It is bad. I would take Social Outcast over them for sure. Then we got R-Truth versus Curtis Axel out of nowhere, speaking of Social Outcasts. And during this quick-ass match, Goldust does come down, and he tries to help out a little bit, throws Adam Rose in, throws R-Truth out of his game, and he gets rolled up, pinned, and that's that, pissing off R-Truth. So the Golden Truth thing might happen, it might not. I'm sure it will happen, and go to the merch link. There's a Golden Truth shirt in there. You might like it, you might not, who knows. But they were got some good reviews on Instagram. That's what it was. So then we move on to the main event, what we're all hoping for. The guy that's over as fuck is Dean Ambrose. Brock Lesnar right up there with him. Roman Reigns booed to shit. Nobody wanted Roman Reigns. I like Roman Reigns personally, but this was not his time. He had a time, and it didn't last long after TLC, but it lasted for about a month that he was over, and then all of a sudden the crowd just shit all over him. It is what it is. But what I did dig was, the power bombs through the announce tables to Brock Lesnar. Two different power bombs through the announce tables. That was pretty cool. Then they bury him. And then finally we get the back and forth between Reigns and Ambrose beating the shit out of each other. After the second time, when Brock Lesnar comes in and delivers another German suplex while Roman Reigns was going for the Samoa drop, that was pretty sick. And then in the end, finally, Dean Ambrose snaps and he's smashing everyone with chairs. And this turns into the spear finish. Roman Reigns victorious. Triple H comes out, holds the belt in front of his face in front of the WrestleMania 32 sign. And that's where we're going, WrestleMania 32. Triple H versus Roman Reigns, and I don't see I don't know, man. It was cool when Roman Reigns wasn't being booed. And for some reason, the crowd just turned on Roman Reigns quicker than shit. So they're going to have to figure out something in 42 days to get the guy over a little more. Or Triple H just maintains being the champion and takes out Roman Reigns in WrestleMania. What do you guys think? Leave a comment below. Who do you want to win WrestleMania 32? Triple H or Roman Reigns? And where does Dean Ambrose go from here? He just lost the IC belt. Then he loses his chance at WrestleMania 32 main event for the WWE World Heavyweight title picture. So where does he go from now? Man, lots of questions. And what's going to happen between Charlotte, Sasha, and Becky? Hopefully it's a triple threat at WrestleMania. I would dig that. And Jericho, who's his next opponent? Leave your comments below. We'll talk about it, and we'll figure out what's going on. And we're going to talk about Raw tomorrow night. So I'll catch you then.